The Journey of Food, From Taste to Digestion, Part 2. Learning Objectives. A. To understand the journey of food from the mouth to the stomach. B. To understand the importance of salt and sugar solution. C. To understand why is hygienic and balanced diet important to us. Hello friends, I hope you all are in good health. I am back again to help you all become healthier. I hope you remember that yesterday Meenu's mother was telling Geeta, Ramesh and her about the journey of food from taste to digestion. The children had collected a lot of information. However, Ramesh still had an unanswered question. Let us find out the answer to his question. Meenu, Ramesh and Geeta were talking while coming back from school.
Meenu, shall we come with you to your house? We still have to understand about digestion from Mossy.
Yes, Meenu. The answer to my question too.
What was your question, Ramesh?
I want to know how does food reach from our mouth to our stomach?
Friends, let's go. Mummy will be waiting for us. Mummy, Mummy, where are you? We are all here. Now please let's continue our discussion on how food travels from our mouth to our stomach.
Come children, sit and here, eat some fruits. You must be hungry.
Yes, Mossy, I remember. I will chew 32 times.
Excellent job, Ramesh.
Please tell us, Mossy, how does food reach from our mouth to stomach?
Children, do you know where the food goes after we have chewed it?
In the stomach.
Right answer. How does food travel from our mouth to our stomach?
From the food pipe.
Yes, the food we chew travels through the food pipe to our stomach. Then our stomach takes all the nutritious part of the food and discards the unwanted part of the food and sends it forward. Through this, we get energy to work, study and play throughout the day. Children, isn't it a miracle to learn about the journey of food from the mouth to the stomach? Looks like Raja has woken up. He must be hungry. Let me give him some milk.
Mossy, how did you know that Raja was hungry?
Children, Raja is a little baby. He can only express his hunger by crying. Tell me, children, how do you feel when you are extremely hungry?
I get a headache when I'm hungry.
Please don't laugh. My stomach makes rumbling sounds when I haven't eaten in a long time.
Yes, our stomach starts rumbling.
When we haven't eaten for a long time, we feel tired, have a headache. Small children cry. And yes, our stomach also rumbles. Friends, how do you feel when you haven't eaten in a long time?
Wow, Meenu, we have learned so much from your mother. It was fun visiting your home. Geeta, let's revise what we have learned till now. Come on, friends, let's begin. There is a spot on our tongue for different tastes. Saliva mixes with the food we eat and helps us in swallowing the food.
We should eat slowly and chew properly.
Food passes through the food pipe from our mouth and enters the stomach. When we are hungry, our body shows various symptoms like feeling giddy, having a headache, and our stomach also makes noises.
Wow, children, you remember everything. Just then, a neighbor, Sarita aunty, knocked on the door. She explained that her daughter Mala was having loose motions and vomiting. She was feeling very weak. It looks like they will have to go to the hospital. Mother made a salt and sugar solution and advised Sarita Kaki to give it to Mala every 30 minutes.
Why did you offer this solution to Mala?
When we are dehydrated due to vomiting, etc., we lose salt and water from our body and we have to replenish it. We should make a solution of salt and sugar in water and give it to the patient slowly. Mala was not able to retain anything because of vomiting and loose motions. Therefore, this solution will give her some energy.
In my school, Game Sir also gives us the same after we play in the sun. Why is it so?
Because you lose salt and water through sweat while playing. Hence, you have to replenish it as it will give you instant energy.
Okay, now I understand.
I hope, friends, all of you have understood how salt and sugar solution is important during loose motions and vomiting. Mala was better in a few hours. Mother advised her mother to give her salt and sugar solution every 30 minutes and offer her soft food like khichdi and yogurt.
Mummy, our teacher has explained that we should avoid fried foods. She says that if we only eat fried food, we could become obese. Is it correct? But I like to eat puris a lot.
Yes, she is right, Meenu. If you eat less food or an imbalanced meal, and if you overeat or eat fried food, then you could become malnourished or obese. We should all eat a balanced diet, exercise regularly, and keep our surroundings clean.
I understand. Now onwards, I will eat a few puris, but also eat green vegetables and fruits.
Mossy, Ramesh never finishes his tiffin. He always wastes food.
Children, you should never waste food. There is scarcity of food in some homes because of certain reasons. Hence, you should never waste food.
I understood, Mossy. I will always finish my tiffin.
Yes, you better do so. Otherwise, we will take all your mithai.
I hope all of you will remember these interesting facts about the journey of food. Now, all of you should go and play and then return to your home on time. The children thank Meenu's mother and went out to play. Friends, hope you enjoyed the journey of food from tasting to digestion. Hope you will remember the things learned through this video. So, from now on, eat healthy, stay healthy.